Network functions virtualization is moving from proof of concept trials to a pre-deployment phase this year. The promises of agile service creation, fast time to market, and significant OPEX reductions are driving investments for NFV-based services. NFV and SDN are also critical technologies to fully realize the benefits of cloud computing. Cloud-based services are dependent not only on virtualization technology itself, but on the efficient management processes that remain in the critical path to agility and low cost. CSPs need to think about how their management systems will support the design, transition, and operation of the virtualized and non-virtualized infrastructure. Key business processes such as self-service, scaling up and down resources, and delivering a high-quality, reliable cloud service will require sweeping changes in the existing management framework. Before we investigate how to prepare the management system for NFV and SDN, let's look at the current state of the market and who's doing what. Many CSPs are in a proof of concept phase. Working closely with key suppliers, CSPs are proving out NFV and SDN in different parts of the network. We see evidence in the market that CSPs are targeting key parts of their network where new technology will be deployed and applying virtualization to it makes sense. This is certainly true for virtualizing the EPC. Other areas such as virtualized CPE make sense in reducing the order to service cycle times. Why is NFV and SDN garnering so much attention? In many respects, it's an admission by CSPs that today's networks are static networks with fixed units of capacity that are not able to deliver the business agility that customers expect in the future. The management systems are not designed to create new services quickly. Completing a service order takes weeks and sometimes months, and the billing systems require expensive modification for changes in new service plans. Virtualization of the network means that the management systems must become more modular and flexible. The European Telecommunications Standards Institute, ETSI, has developed a specification for managing the NFV architecture. It comprises three layers: the VIM, VNF Manager, and the Orchestrator. The work completed by ETSI on MANO to date has had some real benefits in bringing clarity to managing the virtualized resource layer. However, details regarding the reference points to the OSS-BSS components have been notably absent, and the ETSI NFV ISG Working Group does not have any intentions on defining detailed specifications in this area. Instead, it's been left in the hands of the open source community and the telemanagement forum. Broad areas of the management stack are impacted, directly and indirectly, by the technology of virtualization and the business demands of exploiting it. In particular, virtualization greatly impacts service creation, policy, analytics, charging and business model definition, self-service, and of course the domains defined by ETSI MANO. Appledore Research Group has developed a market taxonomy to help navigate the migration of management software systems. Before I dive into the market taxonomy, I wanted to highlight the business benefits that come with NFV and SDN in the context of service lifecycle management. This image provides an example of what CSPs should expect when moving from a non-virtualized network to a virtualized network. In building a business case, OPEX savings will vary depending on the size of the operator and the type of service being virtualized. In this example, we look at the virtualization of the enterprise CPE. In the non-virtualized network, service creation cycle times could be as much as 6 months when factoring in changes to existing order management, activation and billing systems for launching a new service. After this process is completed, the service must then be scheduled, products delivered, a truck dispatched, product installed, and the network activated. And the validation of these services must be operational. This can take another 2 to 3 months depending on the number of remote sites and network technology that's supporting the connectivity. Let's fast forward to a virtualized policy-driven architecture. In this process, the service creation environment is executed using agile software development techniques. A catalog-driven data model enables the service provider to develop composite services rapidly. Services can be created in hours and not months. The management and orchestration of the virtualized services is driven off the catalog that uses a data model linking the product, in this case the virtualized CPE, to resources such as the server, network, and other security-based services. Service chaining is applied to instantiate the necessary resources and set up network connectivity. This is handled in the existing OSS and NFV systems. Once the service activation is complete, continuous monitoring occurs to feed information back into the management system and automate any configuration changes that are necessary due to service disruption. Let's look at the major systems in the OSS-BSS domain that will support virtualized services and the telco cloud. I will start at the bottom of the resource control layer. The resource control layer handles the instantiation, configuration, start and stopping VMs, monitoring, and decommissioning compute, storage, and network virtual resources. The coordination of these functions is directed by the VIM, the VNF manager, and the controllers. The VIM creates and manages virtual machines and virtual functions. It operates at the lowest level of the virtualized management stack and coordinates activities with the VNF manager for the instantiation of the compute, storage, and network. The VNF manager will manage the VNF's life cycle, including setup and teardown, monitoring and managing VNF failover. Controllers will manage the lifecycle of the virtual and physical infrastructure and the network resources. Specialized controllers such as SDN will manage the network data flows for efficient traffic management. The service creation management systems contain a set of tools used to design, create, and compose new products and services. At the heart of the system is the catalog. The catalog is a federated database, and it is used during the PLM process to create product offers from reusable components. We believe its role will expand to drive decomposition of orders and composition of fulfillment workflows, as well as other process actions as well. It consists of data models that comprise the product, service, and the resource. Data model relationships exist that can be used during service creation to support fulfillment, charging, and assurance workflow processes used in the runtime environment. Products consist of services which are made up of resources in the catalog. DevOps is characterized by lightweight, pre-developed scripts that help to simplify complex, bespoke OSS processes. Applied to telecom product and service operations, we think that DevOps means prepackaged, highly agile, componentized workflows that are defined concurrent with a catalog service component and developed by the service expert for reuse. The management and orchestration systems are a collection of both shared resources and new systems that provide the runtime execution of workflow processes. These include order management, activation of the network, and application policy-based flow control rules. Order management systems control and report on the process of fulfilling service orders. I will highlight a few key functions performed in the Mano layer. One key area of growth is policy management, which consists of a policy decision point, PDP, and policy enforcement point, PEP. The PDP is a software system used to define and control network resources. Most deployments today are 3GPP compliant PCRFs used for traffic management or tiered data rate plans, and a tight linkage exists with real-time charging software systems in the policy and charging control subsystem of IMS. Rules are defined against both subscriber profiles and network resource control parameters. Profiles and rules are defined centrally and distributed to the policy enforcement points in the network to control a subscriber's traffic. Policies are executed by policy enforcement points, which may be applications, intelligent routers, or any other bearer layer device. The vast majority of PEPs today are GGSNs or edge routers. Policy evolution in the virtualized network will expand its role into many data-driven parameters that define the instantiation, performance, security, availability, location of VNFs and SDN flows. Another area of importance is network analytics. This is a software system that accepts network-based performance monitoring data, network event data, and application data flows to correlate cross-domain quality of service and service-impacting events. Any state changes that impact the service or the subscriber, KQIs or KPIs, will trigger events. Predictive analytics is also being applied to the system. I will complete our market taxonomy with a quick overview of the final two management software domains. Customer experience analytics bridges the management of the technology with the customer experience in buying, consuming, optimizing each of the services. I should add that the use of big data is a key source of real-time and contextual data that is fed into the CEA system. It comprises three components. The first component is a data model. It provides contextual data that links customer profile data to location and the network usage of the devices. It also provides awareness of customer impact and relevant offer campaigns used in the customer lifecycle. Second is the analytics engine, which will correlate real-time data with historical data. It supports event streaming and queries to Hadoop, business intelligence systems, and data stores for supporting business decision analysis. The third component provides customized reporting modules that are tailored to support specific business outcomes. This includes improving the customer experience, personalized marketing campaigns, network optimization, and fraud detection. The final software system provides access to customers, partners, and other internal employees that will leverage the capabilities of the telco cloud. The API Gateway is a software product that provides authorization, accounting, discovery, reliable delivery, redirection, and other common functions to support external API exposure, which is governed under business models such as record usage for charging. The storefront and portal handles customer and partner interactions, including onboarding, authorization, authentication, purchasing, and self-care. That completes a very quick overview of our market taxonomy. Our next video will assess the supplier landscape and provide a portfolio assessment of each of the capabilities and a rating system for the top 15 suppliers in the marketplace. If you want to understand how the market is evolving to manage NFV, SDN, and cloud services, and the different approaches CSPs are taking to transform their operations, contact us at appledoreresearch.com. Or you can purchase our framework report, Managing the Telco Cloud, NFV and SDN's Role in the Existing OSS Domain.